This is a story only a brother and son could tell, and I don't know how to say this to you, Todd Fisher. I'm so glad you wrote this book. I wish, obviously, the circumstances weren't in it. Well, for me and for everyone else, Debbie Reynolds, of course, and Carrie Fisher's legacy as written by son and brother. Todd Fisher's here. We're glad that you're here.
Thank you.
Did your mother die of a broken heart?
Not a chance. She was, you know, I was put on this earth, born, to be Carrie's companion, literally. My mother chased my dad down and got pregnant with me, and just so Carrie wouldn't be alone. Later, when Carrie passed, my mother looked at me flat out and said, I need to be with Carrie. And then I was like, yeah, right, sure, of course, some day. But I was this close to her. Mm. And within 30 minutes, she fell asleep and left the earth. And so there was she was not even in tears. I was the one in tears. In fact, I was kind of wondering why she wasn't in tears, and instead she had this plan she never said, she did say it, but she, you know, it's like, how can you predict something like that? How do you call an exit?
I've had experience with elderly relatives where I do feel you will it to a degree.
Well, that's
sort of continue or
well,
not.
Well, and
continue.
Being Molly Brown, you know, you call it all the way.
Right. Absolutely.
She did.
Wow. So when that happened, what was your...
Well, I mean, obviously, I didn't know what I was looking at first, and then we ended up taking her to the hospital, and then they said she had had a hemorrhage, brain, you know, in the base of her spine, and there was no way she was coming back. And at that point, the lights went on in my head. I was just like, well, of course, she willed herself off the earth. But, you know, initially, when you're going through, you're rushing and you're trying to react to things, you don't know what's going on. But in hindsight, within a matter of a few hours, I knew exactly what had happened.
Wow. Your mother and your sister, and this is an adjective people use a lot, but truer words were never spoken, were both really characters.
Oh, yeah. Well, I call them these old, you know, like the movie Carrie wrote about them was These Old Broads.
Right.
And funny enough, Carrie was a broad, too. You know, she just hadn't the title yet, but now she's earned the title. And they were powerful girls. They were inspirational girls, you know. And now that they're not with us, you know, they have left us with so many things, so many great stories and great movies and great, just a great, shall we say, examples in life.
Let's talk about that. Tell me about their examples as both mom and sister.
Well, as my mother was a spectacular mother in the most traditional sense of the word. But imagine being this great traditional mom while balancing a career. Especially a career of her magnitude. That's a trick, because I had a lot of friends that had other parents in the business and they suffered, shall we say, the hand of a lot of nannies.
Sure.
Right.
I was drug around from set to set to set, I mean, all the way to Colorado, you name it, we were there. And, you know, at the same time, managing to instill values and love while all that's going on. Not so easy.
And then your sister, and it was very funny because we were talking off air, and I started the story and you finished it because you knew exactly. Carrie Fisher had been here a couple of times and was always great on the air, but often erratic off the air, and used to lay on the floor here, but then before the light came on.
Right. Well, that's how we're trained, to lay on the floor until the lights come on. And then you come to life. We all, in show business, in effect, my mom did sort of certainly trained us, and the show must go on. So maybe, you know, she's probably exhausted, who knows what, but you know, when that light comes up, now you're on, she probably did her show, did a great job, and then laid back down and went, out she goes, you know, she's had it. But no, she was a true professional as well, and trained by the ultimate professional.
I don't know if this is the right word, and there's so much material and obviously physical items they have left behind. Do you miss them, or do they live on? Or?
Well, I obviously miss them deeply, but at the same time, the legacy that they did leave me, the personal items that are left behind are amazing. We have warehouses full of stuff. My mother has amassed an incredible collection. I have most of her costumes still from Singing in the Rain, Molly Brown, you name it, as well as others, Gene Kelly, Donald O'Connor. That's part of her legacy. I decided to hold on to those pieces. I think it's important. It'll probably end up in the Academy Museum here in Los Angeles.
Oh, perfect. That's exactly where it should be.
Right. Well, but at the, you know, for decades, that was never happening. Right. My mom was frustrated endlessly by that whole saga. But finally, you know, we see stuff arising from the ashes.
And I asked you this because this was another memory I have of Carrie, the great dog, Gary Fisher. Where is Gary Fisher?
So Gary lives with Carrie's former assistant. And Billy, my niece, decided that, especially during that moment of loss, that it would be the smoothest thing for Gary to be with her, because they had been together for a couple of years. And so that was decided that was the easiest thing. You know, I also tell a lot of stories in this book about pets. Carrie was the worst pet owner in the world, had so many pets, it was staggering, and I ended up with them all. Even to this day, I have her parrot. And, you know, these are great pets, but Gary was different. Mm-hmm. Carrie bonded with Gary. It was the only pet she ever truly bonded with. It was the love of her life, truly.
No, she's talking about Todd. You can meet him signing copies of his book at Movies and Memoirs at Grauman's Chinese Theater in Hollywood. It'll be taking place tonight. The Larry Edmonds bookstore is involved in a special screening of Bright Lights and the HBO documentary, which was just terrific as well. Good to see you this morning.
Thank you
Thanks so much.
Great talk.
We'll jump right back here in a minute.
Thank you, guys.